Hello and welcome to Siddhganga Academy YouTube channel, Siddhganga Academy for Competitive Exams. So we have started this initiative wherein we will be covering the daily current affairs through the multiple choice questions, that is MCQs. So let's start with the first question. Which is the Southeast Asian nation in the news where there is military coup overthrowing the democratically elected government? Is it Thailand, Malaysia, Myanmar, or none of the above? So the answer is Myanmar. So the second question, pro-democratic leader Aung San Suu Kyi belongs to which country? Thailand, Malaysia, Myanmar, or none of the above? The answer is Myanmar. So this is picked up from the news article, that is here we can see China is concerned for the safety of citizens in Myanmar. So there was a military coup in Myanmar on February 1st, wherein the democratically elected government was overthrown and military has taken up the administration of the Myanmar. So China is concerned for its citizens there who are staying in Myanmar. So here we can see the statement from Chinese government. Attacks on Chinese factories injured. Beijing said it was very concerned for the safety of its citizens in Myanmar on Monday after Chinese factories were attacked and a bloody crackdown on pro-democracy protests in Yangon. Chinese state media said 32 factories in Yangon were attacked. They think that people who are protesting in Myanmar, they think that the Myanmar's pro-democracy movement, they believe that China has sided with the army since the coup. So they think that the Chinese are supporting the military in taking over the government. So that is the reason they are concerned about the Chinese staying in the Myanmar. So let's go to the next question. Which company has confirmed to build a container terminal in Sri Lanka? So container terminal in Sri Lanka. Is it the Tata Group? Is it the Reliance Group? Is it Adani Ports or none of the above? The answer for this question is the Adani Ports. So let's look at the term, that is the container terminal or the container port. What does it mean? It means that intermediate destination facilities that enable switching containers to switch methods of transport en route their final destination. It means that if this is the port, if this is the sea, if this is this ship that is coming here, so there has to be some logistics wherein the ship carrying the goods has to be distributed to the destination. So it might be either through the air or through the roads. So this logistics is called as the container port. So Adani Ports is taking up this project in Sri Lanka. So you can see here Adani Ports confirms the role in Colombo terminal project. So you can look into this article for further details. Let's look into the next article. Which Asian country has recently banned the burqa? Here you can see and the Pakistanis have raised concern about the ban of this burqa. Is it Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, or Bhutan? The answer is Sri Lanka. So Sri Lanka has banned the burqa, and Sri Lanka was also in news for there was a policy during this COVID-19 where they had bought one policy, which was Colombo's mandatory cremation policy for COVID-19 victims, wherein they did not allow these Muslims to bury, I believe, because in Muslim faith they bury, they do not burn, I believe. So they had objections for this policy, because of which the same thing was challenged in UN Human Rights Council also, and the Human Rights Commissioner of UN had observed this and reported this to the UN Human Rights Council. So this matter is before the UN Human Rights Council. So Sri Lanka is seeking the support of other countries such as India to back the Sri Lanka in this matter. So here we can see that a third of the 47 member council current membership including Pakistan is part of the OIC. Here, that is Organization of Islamic Cooperation. See, this Human Rights Council has around 1/3 of its members as Muslim countries. So Sri Lanka is worried about it. So it is seeking the support of other countries so that it will not be sued in the council. So this is the article in the Hindu paper today. So we have picked up this question from this article. So let's go to the next question. Which constitutional amendment has this economically weaker sections quota introduced? Is it the 101, 102nd amendment, 103rd amendment, 104th amendment? So the answer to this question is 103rd amendment. Here you can see the 103rd amendment, which was enacted in 2019. So it introduces 10% reservation for economically weaker sections of society in admissions to the central government and educational institutions, and also to the private educational institutions. So there was an article today wherein the Karnataka state, here again, the Karnataka state is trying to identify the section of society which comes under this economically weaker section, so which have to be included in the quota. So this was the reason this question is being framed. So let's look into the next question. Which High Court has directed the center and the National Cadet Corps, that is NCC, to amend the enrollment criteria under the section 6 of the NCC Act and include the transgender persons need for their enrollment in the NCC? So till now these transgender persons were not included in the NCC. So you all know that NCC, you might have heard about NCC. It is the wing of the armed forces which trains the school students and college students for NCC in different like for army, navy and air wing. So it disciplines in these matters. So transgender were not included. So Kerala High Court has directed the center and the NCC. So there was a case filed before the court. So after hearing this case, the court has passed this judgment. Here we can see this, there was an act which was enacted in 2019, Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Act 2019. So court observed that if transgender persons are not included in the NCC, it is validity of this act, because this act was primarily brought to fulfill the objectives of the constitution. So the article 14, which talks about the equality before the law and equal protection of law, and article 15, that is the prohibition of discrimination on grounds of religion, race, caste and sex. You can see here transgender are a different sex. So, and also the freedom of speech, article 19 and article 21, the right to life and personal liberty. So court has observed these things and directed this central government and NCC to amend the enrollment criteria and also to include the transgender persons. So let's go to the next question. Who allocates symbols to the national or the state political parties in India? So you have heard about the national parties and the state political parties. Which is the one which assigns the symbol for all this? Is it the Central Home Ministry, or is it the State Election Commission, or is it the Election Commission of India, or none of the above? The answer is Election Commission of India, not the State Election Commission nor the Home Ministry, because State Election Commission basically deals with the local body elections. So there was an article in the Hindu today wherein there was a case before the Supreme Court where the pronouncement of the High Court was upheld by the Supreme Court, and it has directed that the High Court order is the correct one. So it is the Election Commission which gives the symbol to the election, see, the political parties. You can look into this article for further details. So let's look into the next question. Which ministry of the central government has moved the bill in the Lok Sabha to define Delhi LG's powers? LG is Lieutenant Governor of the Delhi. So is it the Ministry of Law and Parliamentary Affairs, Union Home Ministry, Ministry of Labour and Employment, or none of the above? The answer is Union Home Ministry. So you might be aware that there is a lot of instances wherein there is a tug of war between the Delhi Lieutenant Governor and the Delhi government. So there were ruling before by the Supreme Court and High Court as well that the LG is bound by the advice of the Council of Ministers of the elected government of the Delhi Union Territory, but there is a tug of war. So now the Union Home Ministry has taken up this bill. The objective of this bill is to empower the LG. It says that Union Home Ministry seeks to amend the 1991 Act, curb the power of the elected assembly. So this is the reason they want to bring this bill, so that they will have upper hand in the administration of the Delhi. So it is the Ministry of Home Affairs that has moved the bill in the Lok Sabha on Monday. It has proposed that the government in the National Capital Territory of Delhi, means the Lieutenant Governor of Delhi, the bill gives discretionary powers. Here you can observe the bill gives discretionary powers to the LG even in matters where the Legislative Assembly of Delhi is empowered to make laws. Okay, so let's go to the next question. What is the IUCN red list status of the Great Indian Bustard? Is it vulnerable? Is it endangered? Is it critically endangered? Is it least concerned? The answer is critically endangered. So here you can see the Great Indian Bustard. It basically is found in the western part of India. There is a dry land. Here you can observe this dry land. So it is assigned the critically endangered status in the IUCN red list. So here you can know different statuses of the IUCN red list. Here it is the extinct. Here it is extinct in the wild, critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable, near threatened, and least concerned. Here you can see what it says about the least concern. The population is stable enough that it is unlikely to face an extinction in the near future. And near threatened, close to qualifying or likely to qualify for a threatened. So it is just before the threatened category. Here you can see. And vulnerable means facing a high risk of extinction. This is vulnerable. Next, endangered means facing a high risk of extinction in the wild. It talks about in the wild. Critically endangered, we have seen for Great Indian Bustard, critically endangered means facing extremely high risk of extinction in the wild. And we can see the extinct in the wild. So this is the extinct in the wild, known only to survive in the captivity, cultivation, or well outside its natural habitat. So it is not, it will be extinct in the natural habitat. It might be found in zoos or any national parks where it is actually maintained by the zoo or zoo authorities, but it will be extinct in the wild. Here one more last category, that is the extinct. No reasonable doubt that the last individual has died. Irrespective of whether it is in the wild or in the domesticated area, it is not found anywhere, nor even a single species is found. So then it is said to be extinct. So we have picked up this article. So here you can see that Great Indian Bustard, the Supreme Court is talking about the Great Indian Bustard conservation. So this article is between the central government power ministry, wherein it is saying that so it want to lay the power cables. So here we can see the Attorney General K.K. Venugopal appearing for the power ministry. However, submitted that only low voltage lines can go underground but not the high voltage ones. So the Supreme Court has asked whether it is possible to lay down these high voltage lines beneath the ground so that the bird that is flying over the ground will not be affected. So this case is mainly about the Gujarat and Rajasthan, where we find these Great Indian Bustard in large numbers. So Supreme Court has directed the government to take necessary steps. So you can go into this article for further details. So let's go to the next question. Which are not included in the GST? So which are the items which are not included in the GST? So alcohol for human consumption, petrol products and petroleum products, aviation turbine fuel, or is it all of the above? The answer is all of the above. So these are the items which are not covered in the GST. So you know about the GST. It is an indirect tax or a consumption tax used in India on the supply of goods and services. It is a comprehensive multi-stage destination based tax. Comprehensive because it has subsumed all other taxes, indirect taxes, except a few state taxes. Apart from few state taxes, it is covering all the taxes. It is multi-stage as well. GST is imposed at every step in the production process, but it is meant to be refunded to all the parties in the various stages of production. So here we can see the different slabs in the GST. We have around 5 slabs: 0%, 5%, 12%, 18%, and 28%. These facts need to be remembered in terms of economics. You might get a question as well. So let's go to the news item. So here you can see the Minister for State has Anurag Thakur has given some statement wherein he says that if any state feels that the petroleum product should be brought under GST, then the center has no objection in discussing it. The center is ready to consider the idea of reducing the tax on petrol and diesel. The state should be also consider it. So there is a lot of discussion going on in the in our country about the rising prices of the petroleum products. This is with respect to that. So these are the news items for today. We hope to bring in the next coming session or tomorrow, we'll bring about the questions for the current affairs of 16th. So hope this initiative finds some use to you.